Okay. Well, so you should wear a mask. Oh my god. You should wear a mask while you do this. I forgot. Oh my god. Hi everybody, welcome to my channel. My name is Evan and this is one of my guinea pigs, Willow. And today we're going to be giving him a poop impaction cleaning. Now that sounds kind of gross, and it is. I mentioned this one time at work to my coworkers. I was like, oh, there's this thing with the guinea pigs where they have poop in their butt. And they were just so disgusted. I will never forget that. They did not want to hear from me for the rest of the day. So if you haven't heard of it before, this is a problem with mostly the male and mostly the older male guinea pigs, where right above their butthole, there's like a little pocket that holds poop. I don't know what purpose it has and like why it's there. Like, why is there a pocket above a, I don't know, but it is there. And poop sometimes gets stuck in it. And with the male guinea pigs, as they get older, it could get harder and it could just collect more and more. So apparently it's something that you should be doing for your guinea pigs every couple of months. It is not something that I've ever done for my guinea pigs. This will be the first time that I've ever done this impaction cleaning. And right now that I'm starting to film this video, I do plan to only do it for Willow, but I may give it to my other guinea pigs as well. I'm not sure if I'll do that in this video. We'll just see how that goes. If you want to make sure that you're updated in case that video does come in the future, make sure that you subscribe so that you don't miss any more videos from me. And then if you also hit that notification bell, then you will get reminded when my videos premiere every Sunday morning. So yeah, we're just gonna get started here. I have everything that I need. I have my gloves. I have paper towels to put the little poop on. I have a cup of water to dampen these little Q-tips in case that is necessary. And then as you can see here, Willow is just on top of like a bunch of fleece. There's two fleece on this table. And then there's this U-Haul blanket that I have under him as well. He's being really stable, by the way. He hasn't moved really at all. As soon as they gave him lettuce, he's like, you know what? I'm fine here. I was about to say that I'm gonna start, but I'm not sure. I just feel bad, like, interrupting his lettuce eating. I mean, this is, like, his favorite part about being a guinea pig, just being able to eat lettuce. I'm just gonna wait a few minutes. Okay, I guess I could prepare by putting on my gloves. Oh my gosh, he's walking around. He's like, oh no, what is gonna happen here? The last time they came on the table here is for Christmas pictures, so I don't think they should be too worried. And they had so much lettuce because, you know, the lettuce kind of goes with the Christmas colors. So, oh. Oh, hello. Come on, come back over here. Come on. I'm trying to think about the proper technique to do this. If you want to know, I learned about this impaction thing from the LA Guinea Pig Rescue YouTube channel with Saskia, and I'm going to be doing her technique. I'm linking the video down below. As I mentioned in other videos, that is the one channel that I go to, that I reference when it comes to anything like guinea pig care related, especially stuff like this and with health checkups and stuff that I'm just not too skilled with. And if you like need support with that, if you need resources, again, Saskia from LA Guinea Pig Rescue, go there, watch her videos, and get educated about guinea pigs. I'm just so nervous. He could feel that too. Let's see. So I pick him up, and I believe what she had said is to, like, I don't know if you can tell, I have another camera right here, so if you put your little their little paw in between your hand right there, that will give you control over the guinea pig. But I think he's still, oh, no. He's not happy with that. Oh my gosh. Oh my god, now, this is kind of gross. Oh my god, and then you're supposed to put your little other hand right there. Oh, Willow. Oh my gosh. Okay, so you put your finger, then you do this with a little butthole. Oh my god, I can't believe I'm doing this. I got one little tiny piece of brown. Honestly, right now I looked in there, it didn't look as bad as I thought it was gonna be. I thought it was gonna be nasty. His butt looks... I guess we could show you, right? Willow, can you show the camera your butt? Put your butt up to the camera. Yeah, I don't know if you could see this. Oh my gosh. Yeah, it looks nasty. So I thought that was the impaction, but I mean, maybe I did it wrong. Let's try it again. Hey Willow, come on. I have a little cup right here with some water. It looks like an espresso cup, because it is. So I got my Q-tip, dipped it in some water. Let's go. Willow. He's actually being kind of calm. There's some wood shavings in there, it looks like. But overall, it looks fine. So I will be including below some videos from Saskia for the proper technique of how to do this in case you can't really, you know, gather it from my video. But right now I looked in there, it did not look that bad. There was like some wood shavings and some little, you know, nasties in there. But in those videos that I've watched, it was like a big giant, you know, hunk of like some dried, I don't know. I don't even want to say it. Well, I kind of just, I just said it. But right now I looked in Willow, it did not look that bad. Like I was kind of pulling it back a little bit, even his little pee-pee was coming out. And yeah, it didn't look that bad. So I'm just going to try it again and see what I find. I do have some more Q-tips. And also, judging by Willow's not too bad impaction, I'm just not going to do the other guinea pigs because they're younger than him. The reason I choose Willow for most of these things is because he is the oldest one, so most of the like care stuff will come to him first. Let's go ahead, dip our Q-tip in some water again. And also another technique that I've seen from Saskia is to use olive oil. I don't have olive oil, we only have vegetable oil right now, so olive oil is another thing you can use to kind of like loosen it up down there if it's too dry. Okay Willow, one more time hopefully, one more time. Let's go. Okay, doing good. Let's use this hand. Let's try that this time. Yes? Can you please let me put my finger here? Okay. There we go. Oh wow. Okay. Make me a little guinea piggy. Oh my gosh. Okay, well, so you should wear a mask. Oh my god, you should wear a mask while you do this. I forgot. Oh my god. I think I'm done. I think that's it for this video. But I did find something. Look, I'll show it to the other camera. I did find something. This is the most that I could find in there. It didn't look that bad. I've seen other videos where it was just nasty in there, and this was not nearly as bad. So good job, Willow. Your butt isn't nasty. Good for you. So now, Willow, you get to eat lettuce. Yay! Here, come over here, Willow. Wheek, wheek. Oh! That's Lionel. Come on, Willow. You wanna get your butt clean? Maybe then. Come on. Yay. It wasn't so bad, was it? That was actually kind of nice. You like getting your butt clean, don't you? Well, thank you so much for watching this video all the way through the end. I really hope you enjoyed it, learned something, and were not too grossed out. If you did enjoy it, make sure to like the video, subscribe to my channels, and watch more from me. And also leave a comment down below with any other advice or tips or questions to do with poop impaction. Otherwise, I will see you all later this week. Bye!